What's going on, guys? My name is Brennan and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how I took $200 and turned it into $2,000 in one day trading options for the first time. Now, before we get started, I greatly appreciate it if you haven't done so already to subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you stay up to date for all that future content, and leave a like on the video. It helps support me, helps support the channel if you guys are enjoying the content, and yeah, let's get started. Now, if you're a returning subscriber, you'd probably realize by now that on my screen is not my M1 Finance portfolio. It is my Robinhood portfolio. And for those of you guys that don't know, I do dividend investing on M1 Finance. I used to be on Robinhood, and I'm slowly transferring some money here. So these two things right here are my only things left over, SPHD and NERV, that I'm waiting to transfer money over, just waiting for the market to correct a little bit more. But I decided for the first time the other day to trade options. Now, keep in mind, I have little to no experience with options. I literally just started because a coworker at my job was talking to me about them. I've known about options for a while, but I never decided to research. But just in the past week, I've done a lot of research just to kind of educate myself whether or not I'm going to do it. And I decided to take a hit, and it actually just successfully blew up this past Friday. Now, for those of you guys that don't know what options are, they're basically when you buy a contract stating whether or not you think the stock is going to go up or down. So you're betting on whether the stock's going to go up in value or lose money and decrease in value. Now, on Robinhood, if I go here on a stock, for example, Wayfair, and I click trade options, there's a couple different things here. There's an expiration date of when my option is going to expire. Think of it like a coupon. If you got a coupon to go to Burger King, it expires on a certain date. So the contracts expire by a certain date, and you can buy or sell. I just do buy right now because I need to learn more. Like I said, I don't have a lot of experience. But basically, if you're buying a call, you're stating that the stock and you believe the stock is going to go up in price. If you're buying a put, you believe the stock is going to go down in price. So looking at the one day chart here, this is on Friday. It's Saturday when I'm filming this video, but on Thursday, I had bought my first two option contracts. I bought puts on two stocks. I bought one on Wayfair and I bought another one on Apple. I was betting that the stock was gonna go down. Now, if you look at my portfolio here, it was at $2,000 basically that morning on September 4th. This was Friday. It was daily dialing around, but as the morning kind of passed, my account was spiking up, and you'll see that it went all the way up if I show you here. Plus $2,226 up to $4,000. Now, the reason you see it dip down is because here, disclaimer, I didn't sell the options like a complete idiot. I'll explain why in a second, but I didn't sell, and basically I only took a profit of like $200+. Very sad about that. I definitely learned a lesson for the future, but I was up $2,000. You can see that right here. I'll explain what I did in a sec. So if you look right here, I bought a 118.75 put. I basically put $114 in on this contract, betting that Apple was gonna go below 118.75. Pulling up the chart of Apple, it was at 122 pre-market on Friday. I bought it on Thursday, obviously, but it was at like 122 on Thursday. It dropped all the way down to 111. So I profited on this one. I'd say I was up about $700, $800 on this one. I didn't sell. And the reason I didn't sell, I'll just get it off the back, is because I woke up that morning, 9:30. My account was up like 400. Then 20 minutes later, it was up 1,000. And then I kept getting greedy. This is why I don't like trading, but I got greedy. It went up to 2,000, and I went to the gym. Went to the gym for an hour, didn't check my phone. As soon as I came back, the market was recovering and my stocks dropped, and all of a sudden my options weren't worth as much. You can see the recovery right here. Like I said, 122, it went down to 111, and this was when I was at the gym. I'm so aggravated. I went to the gym. I came back at like went to the gym about 10:45, came back around 12, and around this time it was already recovering, and it got back all the way up to like the 120. So I basically was almost breaking even almost when I actually sold it. Now, my biggest returns were here on Wayfair. So I currently have an open contract for Wayfair, a put, betting it's going to go down again. I just believe it is. But if I go down here to my history, I bought a $250 put, put in $100. So look at this. I put $101 in for this $250 put. So I basically was betting that Wayfair was going to go below 250 or at 250. So it was at 270 that morning. Look what it went all the way down to, 235. I was up about $1,400 on this individual contract by itself. And keep in mind, I only put $100. Now, like I said, I went to the gym. Here we go. Came back around 12. It already recovered. And I'm still aggravated right now. I'm in my emotions. I'm in my feelings because I was up 2,000, didn't sell, and I only made a profit of like 200 on both together. But I think this is just something that I need to learn more about and for the future and keep my mind open. Now, I'm pretty frustrated, still in my feelings because of the decision, but I definitely learned some things about options there and that single trade alone. And if you look, like I said, I woke up 2,000, went all the way up to $4,000. I could have sold out, used that money, but instead, I went to the gym, and literally, as I was at the gym, just look, it just declined, declined, declined. I wasn't really checking my phone. I was working out, putting in work. effort, and it went down, and I'm back to where I was in the morning. I still gained a little bit, but like I said, it was definitely a good experience to learn about options, and yeah. So just a disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor. This is my first time trading options. I'm not saying you should trade options, not saying that this is how you do it. I'm just telling you what happened to me. This is all for entertainment, and like I said, turned 200 to 2,000, but I didn't get to sell out. Now I know for future reference, but other than that, yeah. All right, guys, that is about it for this video. Like I said, I'm gonna get more into options in the future. I'll keep you guys posted if I make any big gains and keep you posted on everything going on. If you do want to start investing with Robinhood or M1 Finance, I got two links in the description. Robinhood, you'll get $10 free stock to your account, I'm sorry. And then M1 Finance are doing a credit referral right now to make it where you get $20. It's less $10 here, but they're doing $20 for this month when you sign up using the link. So links are in the description. Leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace. By the way, this is just heartbreaking.